AMT's 1972 Chevy is back, and Model Roundup sent it over to Bill. We've got the entire pickup in this box and the Coke machine, because this is one of the Coke licensed kits. So we'll get to build this sweet 70s Coke machine and the full pickup truck on today's review. Let's take a look at everything that's going to be in the box when you get yours. First up, the chrome tree. We've got the full grill insert. We can easily black those out. We've got the stock wheels. We've got some cross lace wheels as options. We got a custom grill in here as an option. Custom steering wheel, chrome valve covers. We got some nice mirrors on there. We got the nice Chevy logo for the center of the grill molded as its own piece, so we can get that painted and then glue it onto the grill in the right position. Got our rear bumper there molded in chrome. Nice looking piece. We've got a set of four whitewall tires. No name, but they are the whitewall, and they are blackwall on the opposite side. So if you want to do a work truck, you of course can do that. Nice tread pattern, and they are hollow, so they will press over any style wheel extremely easy. One metal axle in the box for you. We got the clear parts for the Coke machine. That's that nice display on the top of the machine with the insertable soda names all along the bottom. You'll see how that goes together. We got a large one-piece glass, windshield and back glass, which is typical for kits of this vintage. And I like it. They go in super easy, so I don't have any problems with that. I always enjoy those. We've got a set of really nice Coke decals. This is for the Coke machine with all the Coke options on there. Coin slot information. We've got dash gauges, numerous license plates, other Chevy logos, tailgate logos, and then a large assortment of Coca-Cola livery in the white and the red. So lots of stuff on there. We've even got side marker lights for the truck. So they do include, it is a Coke branded kit, but there is a lot of Chevy truck specific parts in there for you to use. Now let's switch over to the styrene plastic. Yes, the first thing some of you just screamed, it's molded in red. Well, it is a Coke kit, so it's molded in red. I use Rust-Oleum primers. It's going to be easy to cover that up. It's not a problem at all. First part up is that nice tonneau cover. You can even see they've got molded in stretch marks on it. Where it's pulled over, we've got some wheel backs there on that tree. We've got the dashboard. Steering wheel. Dashboard is really nice detailed on this kit. Check that out. So even if you're not going to use those gauges, you can get that painted up nicely. We got nice manifolds on that 350 with automatic transmission. I'm pretty sure it's an automatic. We'll find out. Nice bed. Smooth details on the bottom. We'll see why in a little bit here. We've got various small parts, air cleaner, brake master cylinder, radiator. We've got the interior tub. It's amazing they got even this amount of detail in something that's such a large tub like that. Door panel detail is not bad. Seat, center console, they've even got some textured detail on the seats there. We've got the Coke machine body. We'll get this painted up. I'm going to do the fake wood grain. I've already built one of these before, and I'll be doing this one too in this kit. So it's like two little kits in one. Have you ever seen the price of these individual soda machines from other companies? They cost as much as this entire kit does. Got the chassis here, one large slab. That's why the bottom of that box is smooth, because it's all covered in this part. The good thing about stuff like this is you don't have to worry about having it be a three-wheel motion vehicle when you're done. All the suspension and wheels all fit on clearly, and it sits level, and we can detail that by hand. We got wheel backs on there. We've got engine parts, cylinder heads, intake, stock valve covers, oil pan, belt and pulley system. And you can dress it up with those chrome valve covers. Last couple pieces here. We've got our bed size. Nice crisp detail on those. Got a pan there. You can see the large for mounts on there. We've got our large hood, big old wash tub size, and our tailgate and box parts. Radiator line. See that nice tailgate? That's where your decal will go right across if you don't want to paint it. They give you two options. And the 72 cab. looks spot on to a 72 to me. Again, that trim, that molding is crisp. The logos are on there. We can cover those with decals or we can hand decorate those to our liking. All the way around and our interior will just snap right in. You can see those two holes in there. We got our inner fenders there. So that is it. That's everything that's in this box sent over by Model Roundup. I'm going to start to glue mine together and I'll be right back. Sub-assembly time for you. It only took one change of the screen. For me, it took about 90 minutes. This kit goes together very easily. Even though you have to completely assemble the box, everything lines up itself and it goes together quite easily. So we've got the dashboard and the steering wheel ready to go on their own little trees. The steering wheel was a little bent. I just warmed it up with some warm water and tweaked it back into place, and now it's straightish, so it should be absolutely fine for the build. We got the manifolds and the exhaust pipes coming down. Normally I would glue those on, but these have very large pins in the back of the manifolds that go into holes on the cylinder heads, so those will be very easy to attach and paint separately. Speaking of that engine, we've got it all together. You can see I've got the distributor and ignition coil already located, the carburetor. It's all going to be painted one color, and then I will hand pick out details with a brush. I love doing it that way, and so that's how I'm going to do it on this build. Nice little 350 on there, nice little small block V8, looks just fine to me. We've got the wheels, the wheel backs with their, well, I forget what they call these things, the little pins attached so it can attach to the chassis. We've got the belt and pulley system together. All just presses together with a little bit of model glue. So I can get this all painted in black and the wheelbacks painted at the exact same time for the stock vehicle. They do have different wheelbacks for the other ones. We've got our reservoir tank and our air cleaner. We'll get those primed up to get them out of the red. Then we will get them painted in their final colors. The Coke machine I'll be doing in two halves. I want a two-tone. The back, same as the truck, and the front we'll be doing up with that 70s wood grain and trim, so I'll want those separate so I can then join them without having to worry about making that demarcation line in between the two parts. But it is a nice little machine, and you're going to see how cool these look when you're all done with them. They're a really awesome diorama piece. We've got the hood ready to go on its own tree. I can just grab a hold of it, paint it, cut it off, and clean it off on the back. The chassis is ready to go. We've got the chassis glued together. It just requires this frame cross member inserted and the front axles glued in. Make sure when you push them in that they are level and that they are parallel. They're straight so that you don't have wonkus, unless you want them to look wonkus, but otherwise it's very easy to line those up. Soak them with a good amount of glue and they will never break off, and our chassis is ready to go. The body is all set up. That box is a lot easier to assemble than you think it would, being a multi-piece box instead of one molding. So I'll show you that in a second. We can just slide them apart. They go together very easily. On the cab, since this is all going to be black anyways, master cylinder, heater box, radiator, all glued in. What I will do is paint the body, then I'll grab my testers, or my Tamiya semi-gloss black, and I will hand paint the inners. I like doing it that way, or you can mask it off and paint. The rest of the cab needs no work at all. So you can see how that turns out. We'll get that primed and start to two-tone it. The body, or the box itself. What I like to do is put the front of the box on this one, which interlocks into the bottom of the box. Then there's large wings on either side of this part that you saw in the part show-off that correlate to two slots in the front of the box. You can push them together. Then you just line up the bottom of the box with the bottom of the rails, the bed rails, and it glues itself together. And lastly, you can attach the tailgate on the back or leave it loose if you want to display it down. I glue mine solid on because I don't want it ever falling off or coming off. And it lines itself up nicely and you don't have any issues. When they go together, you'll see that you've got two slots, two pins with corresponding holes. They go together super easy and sit like so. When they mount on the chassis, of course, they will line up much nicer here. They're kind of loose because they kind of, you know, fall down like that. But that's how they go together. It's a beautiful sized kit. I'm going to start getting everything into paint. I'm going to have to primer everything. The body I'm going to hit with a gray primer first. Then, once I cover up all the red, I can start two-toning the body. That's the best way to do it for me, so that we don't get any ghosting of that red plastic through there. The rest will be done up in blacks, body colors and stuff, which will cover up that red very easily the first shot. I'm gonna head over to the paint booth right now.
Thank you.
Welcome back. Now, we did a whole bunch of work on there, a really long work segment. Show you how I faded the paint, scratched up the bed. Check it out. Looks like a nice old work truck, not all rusted out and rotted out. I just wanted to fade this one a little bit and have it be used quite a bit. And that's what I did. Got the decals on there. All I have to do as far as the rest of the decals on the kit is real simple. Just have to put the marker lights on and the logos, the 350 logos, the Chevy logos on the side, and the marker lights. But the rest is on the vehicle. I did the bow tie in red because this is a custom painted vehicle. It's got the white stripe, and instead of a white roof, I did the red roof and then faded it down. Chipped up the box on the thing from sliding Coke machines in and out. Speaking of that beautiful Coke machine, man, I just love that. That's I like the other machines they've come out with, like the 50s style, but this one from the 70s is my absolute favorite one that AMT has put together. Peeps over at round two. So I love it. I built another one a while ago. Built this one. We've got our interior ready to go. Just a little faded and dirty and mild cracking on those seats. You can see where the work guys sliding in and out of it all the time would have eventually worn down that vinyl seat and tore it up a little bit. So that's what I did with that crackle medium. The dashboard looks awesome. A little bit of fake wood grain in there. We got a lot of cool detail on that dashboard, all easily accentuated like I showed you. On the frame here, we've got the white wall tires. I wanted to leave it. The hubcaps are just a little bit of pitting on the chrome. And then we've got some mild surface dirt and a little bit of rust in the exhaust, of course, from the heat cycles, being the bare metal will rust. The 350's just got a little bit of oil staining, but the maintenance shop at the Coca-Cola dealer takes care of it pretty well, but it's dirty because it's got a good amount of miles on it. I'm going to say this has got, you know, 150,000 miles on it in a moderate climate. They drive it all the time. It's a sweet 72 that still runs, and the owner had this custom painted years ago, so they still use it, have a good time with it. Really, all that's left to do is install the rear bumper, which you can see is still shiny, but I flat coated it with a little bit of that metallic rust just so it looked like a little bit of pitted chrome. Did the same with the mirrors. Those have to go on. The air cleaner has to go on. The radiator hose, once it's all put together, we'll push that interior in the cab, and then we will be all done. I even did under the hood detail under there. Let me pop those two apart so they don't fall. Did it in the black and then dry brushed a little bit of gray on the inside. Got our battery, master cylinder, heater box, and it all looks right and tight. So I'm enjoying this build. Very easy build, very well to go together. I'm going to put the vehicle together, get these last little decals on, and I'll be right back. Another awesome kit out of the archives of AMT, the 125th scale 1972 Chevy pickup with Coke machine included. That's right, for the price of one kit, you get the awesome new mold of these 70s Coke machines. This is my absolute favorite one they've made yet. They've made numerous ones, but this one really takes the cake. This is the second one I've built. I saw these things everywhere as a kid. Even places now have them because they still work. Drop 50 cents in, get a can of Coke. Used to be a quarter. Now it's probably $3 or something like that. It's been a long time since I used a vending machine. So that is it. Now I built this up once as the racer's wedge. This time as the pickup, as promised. I said when this kit came out, I was going to get one. And I did. Model Roundup sent it over. Model Roundup has this in stock right now. Kirk and Jack and the boys will get it in the mail for you. They always pack things so nice, and they get you your product in mint condition. Beautiful model. Easy to work on. I did some custom features like the red bow tie, the entirely red top of the cab. You can go with the factory paint. You can go with custom paint. Being the Coke edition, I wanted to do it a little different than everybody else and their brother. Weathered it lightly, as if this thing's been around since 72, but in a relatively dry climate. I've got Georgia plates on it. It's not going to get a lot of salt rust. It wasn't on the coast. It was on the interior, so it's just going to get a little dirty, and they can clean that off. But that red paint always starts to fade. I love doing the faded paint jobs. It's really easy to do. You just use some craft paint of a lighter color than the actual paint you sprayed on. You dry brush it on. We got craft metallics that I use in the bed. We've got crafts for dirt and wood grain. The milk chocolate is my favorite color to use for simulated wood grain on dashes and equipment. We got some grays to dirty up the engine bay. We got blacks for detail painting and washes. We got the crackle medium for beating up those seats like I showed. And for the undercoating of the seats, just some old Model Master paint sitting around, using it up and having a good time with it. Now, when you get done with this kit, you're gonna have a bazillion decals left. Decorate anything you want with them, stick them on mom's car, I don't care, it's not my car, I don't care what you put it on, and have a good time with it. We've got a detailed 350, not bad detail. We've got a basic under chassis. You can see it's not extremely detailed, it's molded in one, but look at how you can make it look if you just put a little bit of work into it. It looks absolutely fine. Final assembly could not go easier on a model kit. You push the cab down onto the pins in the front, and the box just slides in the back and glues to the back of the frame, and you're all done. That's it. It sets up. The interior is beautiful, highly detailed in there. Got decals for the gauges. Everything looks absolutely wonderful. I love the kit. If they come out with other variations, I'd like to see some other stuff going on with this 72 Chevy. Maybe a flat work bed. I don't know if that was ever available on this kit, but it sure would be cool to do. Maybe someone aftermarket makes one. I don't know. Tell me in the comments. But with this edition, you get that beautiful Coke machine. If you have seen what other companies charge for just a 1/25th or 1/24th scale vending machine, you'd know that getting it with this kit and that machine is definitely worth the price of admission. I will link in the description where you can snag this from Model Roundup right now. As always, thanks for watching the workshop. Build for you at home. Build kit. They're your kits. You build for you. Have fun. Smile. Realize it's just a hobby and relax. We'll see all of you at the next review.